How's it going, guys? Dan here from Who Figure Adventures, and last night was the final ever episode of Inside Number 9. I wasn't able to watch it live. I was at the cinema. I was watching Furiosa. Today, Thursday, I finished work. I'm now getting a chance to sit down and watch it, and I've no idea what to expect. I've stayed off my phone as much as possible, and yeah, I'm pretty excited for it. So some theories that I've got, I mean, Stephen Reese, they could do anything. So I don't really know what to expect. We don't know anything about this episode except for the title, Plodding On. So that could mean anything. But some theories I do have. One of the theories I had is that at least the first half would be a normal Inside Number 9 episode, a bit like Deadline. But the twist for this one would be, as the story goes on, details start to become a bit weird, a bit warped. Like, a character's name would change when someone says the name or something, and stuff like that. But there'd be a reason for that, because we then cut back to Sardines, the very first episode, when everyone's in the cupboard burning to death, and they're telling stories. That's what the whole show has been, them telling stories as they're burning to death. I thought that could be a good idea, and it all brings the show a bit full circle. Another theory is that it's Stephen Reese, but doing exactly what I don't know, and somehow I want him to tie in the bus episode. If it's just the full bus episode, I'll be happy. But I love Inside Number 9. I'm so sad to see it end, but it's been a great run of 9 seasons. I just really don't know what to expect. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you'll remember for Halloween a few years back, I think going back to Peter Capaldi era of Doctor Who, I did a reaction on Halloween to The Howling, the 6th episode in the first series, I think it is, and that's the first episode that I properly watched, and since then I've just become obsessed with the show. I've loved it, I've watched all the episodes, and I've always been a huge fan of Stephen Reese from League of Gentlemen, and everything else that they've done, they're just brilliant. So, I'm pretty sure they're going to pull out all the stops for this final episode, and I thought I'd do a reaction to it, because it's quite a special occasion and could be quite a big episode. So, yeah, without any further ado, well, the titles. Okay, so we're set at some sort of bar, close for a private event. Plodding On. Oh, Catherine Parkinson! That was good over the link to Sardines then. Why are all the doors number 9 then? 9th birthday party? My god, this is like Sardines!
Have you seen Reese or Steve yet?
I saw Reese.
Oh, right, okay, so this is real life.
Still, you know. Nine series.
Nine series. Oh, so they had some kind of.
It is good, it is good.
Party, yes. For the show,
play to them.
Oh, Amanda Abington.
Hey, Tim, how you doing?
Who's that?
Catherine Bloody Parkinson.
Oh, but. She's.
I'm Catherine Parkinson.
Of course you are. The other one then. See you shortly.
Ooh, okay. It's still there.
Wow.
Hello?
Catherine, it's Anne Reed. Can you let me in?
Fucking hell.
Yeah.
Love her.
Hi, Anne.
Oh,
I hear
bless her.
You scored some good snow from the dummy man on Deansgate. Any chance of a quick toot? You're in luck. Look at the spare line, haven't you, Tim? Oh, bless heaven.
Hello, my liege. How
Robin
are
school with?
Great to see you.
Hi, Robin.
It's absolutely.
It's going to be spot for celebrity this episode, isn't it?
So, what's next for you both? What have you got lined up?
Yes, actually, we're doing a comedy drama for BBC, playing detectives. It's called Plodding On. Could do specials if we wanted.
Oh, right.
Ooh. Well, that's good.
Could we be getting
married? People always kept up talking to me about the bus episode.
That yeah, never happened.
No, some of the fans were disappointed we didn't actually do it. In fact, I'm starving now. I'd really love to chow down on your...
Shepherd's bush.
Cheese and ham sandwich. Here, sugar tits. Pass me that rag so I can wipe my dipstick. There's a good girl. Oh, no, Amanda.
Wait.
Or a bloody merrily merrily, so I got you both.
Ah, bloody merrily merrily. Yes. I love that episode.
What did you get?
Not just Riddle for the League of Gentlemen reunion.
Anyway, in the end, I thought, fuck it. You only live once, so I said yes to the meeting. Mm-hmm. I pretended to be ill so I could be taken off set.
What? What do you mean?
Oh, no, he's going to find out. He's going to find out.
Like you haven't gone far enough.
Exactly, yeah, so I started fitting as well.
Oh,
is he in one of the toilets?
I bet you were brilliant.
I mean, I'd done all my bits. It was only Reese's reverses to do. Mm. In the end, they put my wig on the producer and he sat in for me.
No.
Yeah, apparently there's one scene where if you look really closely, you can tell it's not me.
I bet they actually did that.
Anyway,
I bet if I go back to Control Escape, there'll be a scene where the producer's wearing a wig for Steve.
Can you get my shoes?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, that's just a present from Jack Whitehall. It's not real.
Oh, Jesus.
They're under the table.
Oh, I love that episode. I'm a true way.
In the meantime...
Hello, pod fans. It's Nick Mohammed here with episode number
2. Who else is in this episode?
Of Mountain to Mohammed.
So I'm going to be heading out to Los Angeles, where I'm going to be there for...
I still think he's going to be in the toilet.
Quite a big commitment then, because I thought, weren't you and Reese working on a new show for the BBC?
Well, no, I mean, I'm not going to be doing that now, but to be honest, I wasn't really sure it was the right project for us to be...
Knew it.
..to be doing, but yeah, you know, I never say never, and there's always new ways of communicating with...
What do you make of Steve's new job?
Yeah, it's great news, yeah. I've not really heard much about it. I can't wait for him to explain it all to me.
Oh, God.
Well, there's nothing to explain. You know, you go for an audition, you don't know if you're going to get it, and on this occasion, I got it. So, it's all whims, isn't it?
It is all whims. I mean, when I auditioned for Lasso...
But you don't audition for things when you've got your own project greenlit and ready to go, though, do you?
I can't remember.
I can tell you exactly when it was.
Oh,
I
don't.
There, didn't I? We were laughing because you still had a mic on your face from filming. It was December the 15th.
December the 15th?
Mm.
The afternoon of December the 15th. So was this audition before or after you were rushed to hospital with a suspected brain aneurysm?
So we're creating 9 series of Inside Number 9. It is an incredible achievement. I hope you're not going to smash his head in with a bat.
Jesus.
But at the end of the day, Steve, it's just a television programme. It will be on and then it won't be on. Like you've always said, it'll just be another line on your CV.
Okay, well, I don't want to spoil tonight.
Oh, we don't want to spoil tonight. Well, I'm afraid that ship has already sailed.
If you want to know the truth, Reese, I feel like you've been holding me back.
Oh, you fucking what?
Oh, hiya.
Not now, Amanda.
For fuck's sake, I'm growing a monkey tail here.
Poor Amanda, she just wants to talk to
I want to be me and something in my own right.
Oh, you did Death in Paradise.
I'm not talking about fucking Death in Paradise. I'm talking about big American things with a 7-series character arc.
I thought you were going to die and I was going to lose you. And now I am going to lose you and I've barely got any real friends as it is.
No, oh, Reese. You got Mark.
Reese.
I hope he's there. I hope
we've been
Mark's there.
So long now. I don't even know if we are friends anymore.
What an awful thing to say. Look at everyone that's there. Is that Mark Benton? Oh, Sheila Reid, Elsie Kelly. David Morrissey, Samson Wegg, Horrible History Guys, Zoe Wanamaker. Oh, Jason Watkins. My favourite episode with Bill. I love it. So good. So many people here. This is amazing. Oh, Wuthering Heights. I love that one. So, Mark Bonoff.
Hello?
It is.
Sorry, say again?
Oh, a TV show's been canned, hasn't it?
Oh, good riddance.
Oh, the hair. I've just seen it. Look at all those people. I mean, this is mental.
It's pretty much green lit.
Right.
Mark!
Why are you doing it with Steve? I'm just not sure I want to do another detective thing after, you know...
Midsummer Murders.
Sherlock.
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah. Well, I just thought it would be, you know, lovely. See you, Mark.
Yeah, bye. Fucking hell, that was a close call.
Mark, you've not hung up properly.
There's been a twist.
It's been cancelled.
Has it been seeded?
Unfortunately not.
Oh.
Some other actor's thrown his hat into the ring and the director's really excited.
Who?
Fucking Tim Key.
Well, of course.
Get it now.
I know. If you're going to cry,
don't
cry tears of laughter.
There is a third option.
What?
Hold on tight. Oh, that's Kevin Parkinson. The shop. Yeah, the shop and name's loud. I love that. Oh, Robin Asquith. That's it. Look at all those names. Okay, guys, that was the final ever episode of Inside Number 9, Plodding On, and oh, it was perfect. That's exactly what I wanted. That couldn't have ended it better. I think it's a good idea to have a sort of real life one. I mean, we kind of got that with Deadline, but with this episode, it was just nice to. Let's get a full Stephen Rees, and setting it up a rat party is a really cool way idea, and a good chance to bring everyone back. I mean, you know, there was Mark Bonnard, Sean Gibson, Nick Mohammed, Elsie Kelly was there as well. I saw tons of people there. It was amazing. David Morrissey as well. I mean. What an ending. I just couldn't have asked for anything better. It was a nice way to end the show. You feel like the show has come together, it's concluded. I'm happy they didn't just do another anthology episode. I'm happy it acknowledges the show and does everything like that. I think, you know, it's got potential to be one of my favourite episodes. I feel like there's tons of Easter eggs in there that I'll probably miss, but I also love the fact that they've gone for that third option, which is to do those specials and stuff. So they're kind of still continuing and stuff, aren't they? They've done On the Buses, they've done Robin Askell with School Whips. It was just nice, and nice to see everyone, nice to see Mark Gatiss as well in it. I mean, Stephen Rees they're just masterminds. They are just insane at this show, and League of Gentlemen, Psychoville, everything they do, they're just amazing at. And now I'm just yearning for what they do next. Seriously, like, I cannot wait to hear what they do next. And I really hope they do something else. I expect them to take a bit of a break, but. Yeah, I mean, if they do something like that detective show they were on about, I would love that. I mean, I'd love anything that they do, you know, all the twists, they're just masterminds. If you've never seen this show, I mean, you've got to give it a watch. When people ask me about it, well, I sort of recommend it as a show, people say, like, oh, what's it about and stuff, and I say, oh, do you like Black Mirror? And I say, yeah, I do. I say, it's better than that. It literally is. It's better than Black Mirror. It's not too heavy with the episodes. They're only 13-minute episodes. There's so many to choose from. I mean, what's some of my favourite episodes? I mentioned earlier The Bill is one of my favourite, is my favourite episode, I think. The twist in that one is just one of the best, I think. It's so good that the whole thing was just a ploy to get the money and stuff like that. What else do I like? I like Merrily, not just because of a League of Gentlemen reunion, but the twist is quite a nice, somber, slightly sinister twist, but it's still quite good. Bernie Clifton's show, Western Room, just makes me cry every time. 12 Days of Christine, obvious. White Night In, it's just genius. A whole silent episode with burglars. It's amazing. That's the second episode. Cold Comfort creeps me out. That scares me, that episode. Literally, it properly scares me. But yeah, there's just so many great episodes. The Last Weekend was amazing. That's only from last series. So yeah, it's so sad to see the show go. I'm going to really miss it. But yeah, I really hope they do something else. If not, I'll have to go back and rewatch all of Inside Number 9 and League of Gentlemen. But Steve Rees, amazing. Well done. Take a bow. Just phenomenal. I really did think with the opening couple minutes that it was going to connect to Sardines, because obviously we saw Kevin Parkinson, we saw Tim Key. I really thought that it was going to connect to Sardines, and I was like, oh my god, my theory could be true. Woo, this could be like an all episode, and then it cuts to them all dying in that cupboard. But no, I'm happy with what we got. It was a great final episode. And yeah, thanks for watching. If you have enjoyed this video, please leave a like and a comment. Tell me if you're watching Inside Number 9. Tell me what your favourite episodes are, or if you're going to watch the show and stuff like that. I'm excited to hear your thoughts. Follow me on Twitter at DanWFA. The link is in the description. Now I'll see you next time. Goodbye.